JL Olivia Brooks, and today I am baking homemade ginger snap cookies, which are my mom's favorite.
First, we will start with the ingredients.
We have 2 cups of all-purpose flour, plus an extra 2 tablespoons, 2 teaspoons of ground ginger, 1 1/2 teaspoons of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of fine salt, 1/4 teaspoon ground cloves, 1/4 teaspoon of ground black pepper, 1/8 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, 12 tablespoons of unsalted butter softened, 2/3 cup of white sugar, 1/3 cup finely minced candied ginger, 1/4 cup molasses, 2 teaspoons of ground cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1 beaten egg, and 1/2 cup of sugar that we will roll our ginger dough in.
This is my trusty little mixer right here. But if you don't have one, you can always do it by hand. But if you do, I recommend using this because it's way faster. This is my food processor. I used it to grind the crystallized ginger into little tiny bits. But if you don't have one, it's always okay to use a knife to chop it up. Now I'm going to combine all the dry ingredients with this whisk. Now, adding to my flour, I'm going to add my crystallized ginger, my ground cinnamon, my baking soda, my salt, my ground cloves, my black pepper, my ground red pepper, and my ground ginger. Now, I'm going to whisk it. Now, I'm going to cream my butter and my sugar together. And mix it for about 2 minutes. My vanilla. Now I'm going to add molasses. Smells really good. Let's just get that out. Now I'm going to add my 1 beaten egg. Okay, I'm going to come back once it is whisked. Now, I have all my wet ingredients mixed together well. Now, we're going to add all my dry ingredients. So, you already know that flour gets everywhere when you stir it. So I have this to protect it. Now that I have my dry ingredients mixed in with the wet ingredients, I'm going to turn it on. Right there. Now come back once it's thoroughly mixed. Remember to scrape your sides if there's extra ingredients on it, like flour. Okay, turn it back on. We can do it a little faster since the flour, well, most of the flour is mostly mixed in. This is the consistency it's supposed to look like, right here. Sticky and light brown colored. Now, I'm gonna scrape the sides of my bowl to push all the extra ginger to the middle.
So after you do that,
put the plastic wrap over it.
And then you have to chill it for 1 hour in the refrigerator. And while that's happening, time for me to enjoy some ginger batter. Welcome back. This is 1 hour later, and my dough seems to be done. And don't forget to set your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's just be quick with this and try not to get it so sticky. So you have to roll in the sugar. They're all nice and sugary. There. And as you can see, I rolled the cookies into a ball already and dipped them in sugar. So I'm going to show you a quick example of how I did that. So first, I scooped it with the ice cream scoop, scooped it out of the bowl, and just did this to it to get it nice and round. And then I dipped it in sugar to get all the sugary flavor on it. And it also helps to prevent more stickiness to it. So I did that, and now this is only half of the batch, but I'm going to show you what it looks like when we get all of it. So I'm going to be back as soon as I finish pressing it with this cup. I just finished pressing my cookies. I recommend pressing it with something a little bit like this, a little round edge, like a teacup shape. And I just pressed it, and it's about that size, a quarter of an inch thick. So after I do that, I just sprinkle it with sugar like this to add a little bit more sweetness. And I'll get back to you after these are baked. I just got the cookies right out of the oven, and they smell really good, but I let them cool for at least 5 minutes. But if I let them cool longer, they'll probably be even more crunchy. See, I just put it into one of the cookies. They are delicious, nutritious, so good. I'm gonna eat all of them myself. But it'll be nice. Give one to my mom and my dad and my brother. Mmm. What did you taste now?